This is the anterior view of the scapula. On this video, we're going to focus on several of the important structures that you'll need to know. The first is going to be your coracoid process. It is this structure right here. It's this little process that's coming out. You're going to have your transverse process. It's on the posterior side. Other people refer to it as the scapular spine. It's this right here. And on the posterior side, you're gonna see your acromion process. So let me kind of rotate this a little so it's a little easier to see. Your acromion process, your coracoid process, then you have your glenoid cavity or fossa. It's this depression where the humerus rests or articulates. We have our subscapular notch. You're gonna go back to the anterior view to see that. Your scapular notch. On less budget-friendly models, there's an actual larger, deeper depression, but in ours, it looks a little bit like a groove. Next, we're gonna go to our infraspinous fossa. We're gonna have to go to the posterior view again. And your infraspinous fossa is going to be this region here. Next, and by the way, it's infra as in below the spine, and our supraspinous fossa is going to be this space that you may have noticed here. And this is above the spine. Next, we're going to have our superior and inferior angles. Our superior angle is going to be this right here, this angle. Let me show you from the back, this angle. Our inferior angle is down here. And these angles are formed by the joining of borders. So our superior angle is formed by the medial and superior borders, while our inferior angle is formed by the lateral, note that it's always under the glenoid cavity, and medial borders. Lastly, since we're gonna flip to the anterior side, so we can note the subscapular fossa, that is gonna be this area in here. And if you could rub your scapula, you'll notice the depression in the bone.